Welcome, welcome, welcome Lake Grove kids. Welcome, welcome, welcome Lake Grove kids. Welcome, welcome, welcome Lake Grove kids. Welcome, hello, we're glad you're here.
Welcome everybody, I'm Mr. Mark.
And I'm Miss Leslie.
And we're with Lake Grove Kids.
At Lake Grove Presbyterian Church.
And we are so glad that you're with us.
We are part of the Children's Ministry Program. But before we get started today, we have announcements,
announcements, announcements.
What are our announcements?
Our announcements is what's happening in LGK Reaches Out, how we take the love of God out into the community. And this month, we're supporting the church's sponsorship of Angel Tree Prison Fellowship. That means you can sponsor a family by signing up for them on the website and purchase Christmas gifts for them and then deliver them on December 4th. So go onto the website and you'll find all the information needed. We hope that you'll join in making Christmas special to someone who has a parent that's incarcerated.
And now it's time to worship. Ms. Karen?
God is love. Thanks be to God. God is patient. Thanks be to God. God is everywhere. Thanks be to God. God is kind. Thanks be to God. God is forgiving. Thanks be to God. And the last one is God is in our hearts. Thanks be to God. Amen.
This month in LGK, we're learning all about God's Word, the Bible. And this song is all about that.
The B-I-B-L-E, yes, that's the book for me. I stand alone on the Word of God, the B-I-B-L-E. The B-I-B-L-E, yes, that's the book for me. I stand alone on the Word of God, the B-I-B-L-E.
That's fun. Let's try it again.
Okay.
The B-I-B-L-E, yes, that's the book for me. I stand alone on the Word of God, the B-I-B-L-E. The B-I-B-L-E, yes, that's the book for me. I stand alone on the Word of God, the B-I-B-L-E.
You know, God's Word can also be like a lamp and guide our paths. Mm-hmm. Sing this one with us.
Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. And when I feel afraid, think I've lost my way, still you're there right beside me. Nothing will I fear, so long as you are near. Please be near me to the end. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path.
Sometimes we sing scripture, Psalm 89:1. I will sing of the mercies of the Lord, forever I will sing. I will sing, I will sing of the mercies of the Lord, forever I will sing of the mercies of the Lord. With my mouth may I make known thy faithfulness, with my mouth may I make known thy faithfulness to all generations. I will sing of the mercies of the Lord, forever I will sing of the mercies of the Lord. I will sing of the mercies of the Lord, forever I will sing of the mercies of the Lord.
Amen. Join us in the prayer of illumination.
Let's pray together. Lord, we are ready to listen to your word. Your word gives form to our lives, just the way our bones give form and shape to our bodies. In your son's name, amen.
Welcome, students. I am Professor Can't Live Without Jesus, and I'm so glad to welcome you back to class. Today's class is an anatomy class. Now, anatomy means the structure of the body, or bones. So today's class is called The Bones of the Bible 101. We will be looking at the bones that make up the body and how that helps us discover things about the Bible. But before we begin today, I'd like you to meet a friend of mine. Meet Bonesy. And as you can see, Bonesy is made up of a lot of bones. Bones that are all connected together. And that helps us discover that the Bible is also connected all together. It is one big story about the God who created us, how much he loves us, how much he wants to be our friends. Now, if we turn Bonesy around, we see his spinal column, which is made up of 33 bones. Now, to discover how many books are in the Bible, we are going to do a little mental math. So 33 times 2 equals, yes, you are exactly right, 66. And there are 66 books in the Bible. Now, if we turn Bonesy around, we discover he has one side and a second side, just like there are two sides or two testaments in the Bible. The Old Testament is made up of 39 books that tell the story of God's people, the Israelites, before Jesus was born. And the New Testament, or the other side of the Bible, is made up of 27 books that tell all about how Jesus was born, lived among us, died, rose again, and what happened afterwards. Now, the Old Testament, the first part of the Bible, is made up of 5 parts, just like Bonesy has 5 fingers on his hand. Now let's examine what those 5 parts are. Now, first off, Bonesy, on one of his feet, has 5 toes, just like there are 5 books of law in the Bible. Now, Bonesy also has 12 ribs on this side, just like there are 12 books of history in the Old Testament. And on Bonesy's other foot, where there are another five toes, it reminds us that there are five major prophets in the books of the Old Testament. And last, just like Bonesy has 12 ribs on this side of his body, 12 of the books in the Old Testament are the minor prophets. Now, let's look at Bonesy's head for a moment. And if we look at his head, we discover he has a mouth that opens and closes, very necessary for talking. And that tells us something else about the Bible. That before the Bible was put into words, it was actually stories that people shared with one another. Now, they decided, though, to put those stories into words, and 40 people did so over the course of 1,500 to 2,000 years. And if we added up all of the words in the Bible, they would number over 786,000. More words than Bonesy would have hairs on his head if he had hair. So, we've talked a lot about numbers today in the Bible, so let's do a little review. There are how many books in the Bible? 66. 39 in the Old Testament, the beginning part of the Bible, and 27 in the end of the Bible. In the Old Testament, five of those books were law, 12 were history, 12 were minor prophets, and five were major prophets. And who wrote the Bible? Over 40 different people. Even though Bonesy has lots of bones, just like the Bible has lots of different parts, both are all connected. They are all one big story in the Bible, one big story that points to someone who took on a human body, complete with all of our skin and our hairs and our eyes and all of our bones. A person that was 100% human and 100% divine. And that person, you're right, was Jesus. God loved us so much that he sent Jesus in human form to live among us, to die for us, to rise again so that we could live with him forever. So I have a question for you. When did you first hear about God and how much he loves you? Was it someone reading the Bible to you, or is it someone who was telling you about it? Let's pray today using God's word, because we can do that. We can use his words to create a prayer, and they're called scripture prayers. It means using God's word from the Bible to help us pray. So let's pray this prayer together. Dear God, your words are a lamp to my feet and a light to my path. May I read the Bible this week and have your words show me the way to go. Psalm 119, 105. Amen. We are so glad you are with us this week. Let's close with this blessing that we send to you and you take out into the world.
May the Lord bless you and keep you, and make his face to shine upon you. May the Lord bless you and keep you, and make his face to shine upon you, and be gracious unto you, and be gracious unto you. Lift up his countenance upon you, and give you peace. May the Lord bless you, and keep you, and make his face to shine upon you.
We'll see you next time.
It is good to be together.
Always, always, always.
So long, farewell, goodbye, Lake Grove kids. So long, farewell, goodbye, Lake Grove kids. So long, farewell, goodbye, Lake Grove kids. So long, farewell, see you soon.
Everybody.
God loves you, and nothing will ever change that.